Hey YouTube, today I've got a 2000 Nissan Frontier Crew Cab XE. This one's got the 3.3 liter V6 and an automatic transmission. Today's job is to replace the upstream oxygen sensors as requested by the customer. There's no real problem with the truck. Check engine lights off. OBD2 readiness status is okay. This thing would pass emissions if there is emissions testing in our area. But the owner said that the oxygen sensors are original to the truck, and at almost 140,000 miles, as you can see here, it's probably just a good idea to replace them anyway. So we'll get to the shop, pull it into the shop, and I'll show you how to replace the upstream oxygen sensors on a Nissan with a 3.3. Okay, so we are in the engine compartment here in the shop, with the truck in the shop, I should say. And on these engines, bank one is on this side, bank two is on the driver's side, left side in the United States, and countries that drive on the right side of the road. Anyway, the oxygen sensor for bank one is right here, and this is the easier one to get to. The loom just goes up to the connector right here. So what we'll do is we will disconnect the connector for sensor, which it slides off of its bracket on the valve cover like so. There's a, on the back side, there's a slot that the connector slides into to secure it to the valve cover. So while I have it upside down, there's this release tab that you can pull on or push on. You push on this release tab and then get your second hand, which I don't have in this case because I'm holding the camera. We'll push this and that will release the connector from the oxygen sensor. So let me put the camera down and get that disconnected. Okay, I've pushed that button in and I was able to disconnect the connector. Everything is in good shape here. The reason why we want to disconnect it is because when we loosen the oxygen sensor, we don't want to twist this loom up excessively. So disconnecting it allows us to spin that oxygen sensor right out of there with the appropriate tool. And in this case, I'm using just a simple oxygen sensor. I guess this is sort of a socket, but this is one I tend to use with these vehicles. I'll provide a link in the description below to where you can get one of these. In this case, this was just a simple one that I got from my typical auto parts store. I believe this one came from Advanced Auto, but there's a lot of different manufacturers of these and they all work pretty good. So from here, it's got a slot here so that you don't have to cut the wire. We'll slide it down onto the oxygen sensor. So we got a good bite on the oxygen sensor itself. All right. Hopefully you can see. And from there, we'll attach an extension and a ratchet to break that loose. So something like this, we'll just orient it around so that we can get to it. Let me get this set up and we'll get to you in the next clip. Okay, here's a better view of how I have the removal tool oriented in here. I've got a short little like 3-inch extension or something. 3/8 drive extension connected to my flex head ratchet, as you can see there. These sometimes can be tight since this engine is still somewhat warm. Normally I let it cool down, but a customer kind of wants the vehicle back, so I'll do it with it warm. And we'll just loosen it. All right, I think that's loose. So we'll remove the tool. Remove the tool. This thing unthreads much like a spark plug or something. So we'll go ahead and get this out of here. This is still very hot as the engine's still quite warm, as I said. But I'll go ahead and just loosen this counterclockwise until the oxygen sensor is out. Okay, so something happened here that occasionally happens is the bung that the oxygen sensor screws into on the manifold came out with the oxygen sensor. So what we'll have to do is we'll have to get a wrench on the bung itself, which I believe it's 1.25 inches that fits it quite well. We'll put the wrench on the bung and then put a socket, the oxygen sensor socket, back on the oxygen sensor and remove it from the bung. So this happens every now and then. So just to illustrate what's happening here, we'll put the bung into the wrench that is sized appropriately for this, and we'll go ahead and remove the oxygen sensor from the adapter bushing or bung or whatever you want to call it. So let's see if I can get everything oriented here properly with one hand. Difficult things I do for YouTube. So hopefully I can bust this loose. Holy crickies! All right, so I got it loose. Oh, my Milwaukee light's dying. So I have to switch the battery on that. But anyway, the bung is loose now. I will unthread that from the oxygen sensor, and we'll have to screw this bung back in into the exhaust manifold. So, like I said, this happens sometimes, not a big deal. So once you break it loose, it just unthreads from the oxygen sensor like so. So I'll go ahead and put this bung back into the exhaust manifold and we'll continue on. Okay, we're gonna thread the bung back into the exhaust manifold. Again, no big deal, just be careful if it's warm. Just thread it in by hand. Ooh, it's still quite warm. But as you can see there, it's starting to go. I'll go ahead and use a socket. Like I said, 1.25 inches. I don't remember what the metric equivalent is, but 1.25 inches works really well, nice and tight. So we'll get this threaded on here and bolted back in, and we'll proceed with the next step. Okay, I've got the O2 sensor bung screwed back into the manifold and tightened down. I just went ahead and snugged it down. I don't remember what the torque spec is. You don't have to go all monkey tight on it. Just make it nice and snug. The oxygen sensor I'm using today is a Bosch. 13420 is the part number for the bank one, passenger side bank. Sensor comes with the correct connector, correct pigtail. I believe it's the actual OE manufacturer of the Nissan O2 sensors. And it's got a nice coat of anti-seize on the threads. So we'll go ahead and screw this back into the manifold. So you want to screw it in by hand at first before you put the tool on it and tighten it down. But pretty much like a spark plug, tighten it down until it's snug. And then we'll go ahead and plug the connector back in and slide it back onto the valve cover. And that's it for that job. Now hopefully the video work's not gonna be too poor here. But anyway, we will try to get you a somewhat decent camera angle here. So anyway, I've started the O2 sensor. You wanna thread this in by hand, like I said earlier. Do not wanna cross thread it. If you immediately start tightening with the socket, you will be in a world of hurt. So always start these by hand. And they don't, you know, with the anti-seize on the threads, they usually go pretty quickly. So screw it in by hand until it bottoms out on the bung, And we'll go ahead and slide our tool back on. And basically backwards is how we took it off. So, let's see if I can manipulate everything back down here. Put the tool around the wires like so. Clock that in there. And then we'll get the wrench and possibly an extension or so back on there. And we'll snug her down. Like a spark plug, you don't want to crank on it too hard. You just want to go till it just stops using just hand pressure on a ratchet. There's no need to ever crank on these that hard. All right, so that's done. Now all we have left to do is to plug the pigtail in, which maybe if I'm clever, I can do it with one hand on the camera. Okay. So there's the connector. Make sure everything lines up properly. Don't have to force it, but as you can feel it, you shouldn't have to put that much pressure to get it to click in. If you have to use what seems like excessive force, it's probably because the pins didn't line up quite right. So I suggest pulling the connector back apart and trying again and making sure the pins inside the connector are straight if you continue to have problems with it. But generally they go in pretty easily like this. We'll go ahead and slide this socket on the connector back onto the valve cover. And we're done. We're done with this side. Okay, so that's how you get the O2 sensor on the passenger side bank on one of these Nissan 3.3 liter V6s as found on a Nissan Frontier. Now moving on to bank number two, which is the driver's side bank. We'll want to prep things by getting this blue, typically the factory wiring is blue, O2 sensor wiring out from the valve cover and released from the engine harness. So again, push down on the connector and it should come out like this. It is held in usually by a reusable zip tie like this. So you just pull on the tab and that releases the tag end of the zip tie. Really hard to do on camera with one hand, but so basically you just undo this so that you can free the cable from the loom, and there should be a couple of push fasteners that you have to release. Use a tool like this to get down in there and release it. But anyway, kind of hard to do on camera, but a little pry tool like this. This one comes from PB Swiss, but there's plenty of others that are available on the market. And I'll try to put a link for this tool or a similar tool in the description below. So we got one here to pop, and there's another one closer to the oxygen sensor. I'll go ahead and do that and we'll get back to you in the next clip. Got the reusable zip tie removed and the other fastener that was here snapped off of the back of the engine there. So now we're just gonna work this O2 cable out from behind to where we can get to the oxygen sensor, which is right here, so that we can free everything up, I guess. We don't want that cable twisting around as we're trying to loosen it from, or loosen the O2 sensor, which is right there. Kind of a hard spot. I'll try to adjust my lighting so we can see it a little better. Okay, so I got the cable worked over from the passenger side over to the driver's side, and we'll see if I can focus in on the last fastener. Kind of a pain. Not really a whole lot of room in the engine compartment, but You might be able to see in the center of the screen there, there's one more of those, I guess, Christmas tree type fasteners. For this one, you can use needle nose pliers to squeeze in the ears to release the cable. So that's the next thing you need to do before working on the O2 sensor itself. I misspoke. I forgot about this bracket here that's attached to the master cylinder. It holds a throttle cable. So we'll pop the throttle cable off from the bracket, which just simply pops out of its clips here. Move it out of the way. And then this bracket, usually I can't fit my arm down in this hole with this bracket here. So it has two 10 millimeter bolts that you remove to get that bracket off. I'll go ahead and remove that bracket and then we'll go back to the oxygen sensor right there. With that throttle cable bracket out of the way, we can now focus on the little retainer there. Like I said earlier, needle nose pliers can help you get that pushed out of there. I don't know if I'll be able to get this on camera, being that I'm working around the hood prop and everything else, but we'll see. So we'll squeeze the clips in and then push it through. Which, yeah, terrible footage here. But I did get it pushed through. So now the blue cable should come out. Okay. So now we can work on the sensor removal, and it's not really any different than the driver's or passenger side bank one. So we'll get the socket on there. Figure out if we need to have an extension or something on the tool, and we'll break that free. We're almost done. All right, let's see if I can work around the camera and everything else. So anyway, it looks like I'm gonna have to use a little, what is this, like an inch and a half extension. Okay, ratchet is on the tool, trying to hold the camera and everything. See if I can break this sucker loose. Wow, it wasn't really on there all that tight. Barely felt it snap free, and it appears that we're loose, I think. Let's see. Oh yeah. I saw that oxygen sensor move. I don't know if you guys did. Let me get my tool free of this and unscrew the oxygen sensor and get the new one ready. All right, well, hopefully I can get this unscrewed from here without obscuring things or dropping my phone. Okay, well, I can't get my hand in there with the camera in the way, so you'll just have to take my word for it. I just need to unscrew that sensor and screw the new sensor in its place. But it's just like the passenger side bank one, same concept, just a little harder. Okay, so I don't get accused of not doing the job. It does come out. It's unthreading. Sucker's really hot still. So this is why we let the cable dangle free, so that it doesn't twist up on us. And same thing when we're putting it back together. We leave it free so that it doesn't end up getting twisted. Alright, we're free. As you can see here, it's the same thing, same sort of thing, same style of sensor. So we'll get the new one, we'll thread it into the block. Oh, look, it looks like this one also pulled the bung with it. So I'll have to release this from the O2 sensor, just like I did with the previous one. Alright, so in case you were wondering, inch and a quarter also equates to 32 millimeters. This is pretty much the setup I use to get the bung back in its place over by the driver's side catalytic converter. I don't know if I can get you a better view of it, but kind of right there, centered in the frame, is where the bung sits. Kind of points towards the aft end of the vehicle. So 32 millimeter is what I used, and a rotor head ratchet. I'd imagine you could probably fit a smaller half inch drive ratchet in there, but this is just my preferred tool, I guess. Okay, so once again, I am using Bosch oxygen sensors. Here's the part number for the driver's side bank, or bank two. Like these Bosch sensors because they come with the little doohickey clips that you clip onto the back of the engine block so that the cables don't burn on the exhaust or anything silly like that. And like I said, I believe these are the actual manufacturer of the OE Nissan part. They look identical. I can't find really any differences between this part and the part that came out of the truck originally. So we'll go ahead and screw this into the exhaust manifold, basically backwards of how we took it out. So because of the difficulty of the location here, I probably won't get much footage of getting this screwed in, but it's pretty much just like the other side. Screw it in by hand and then snug it down with a tool and then run the cable back to the connector on the passenger side valve cover. And make sure you route it correctly and then put the bracket for the throttle back on and, reroute everything the way it was, and we're done. So I'll get on to installing that, and we'll see you in the next clip.
Okay, maybe I can get some footage, maybe, if my hand doesn't block the camera too badly or the lighting. It's one of those things. YouTuber problems. Getting you guys a good view and not shaking the camera up too much. Not getting my sleeves caught. So anyway, just threading this on by hand. Takes a little bit to get the threads to catch because we've got to get right at the right angle. And you got the cable trying to twist. So I'm holding the cable up with my other hand to just keep it from catching on anything and getting twisted up too badly. Compensating for the twist with my other hand. And as you can see, I've got this started. Sorry for the crappy view there, but that's as good as I can get you. So now I can put the tool on, snug her down, and then proceed with some of the final steps, which is moving the cable back to its correct spot on the engine. And then we're done. Assuming I can get my tools in. Believe me, this can be done. Ta-da! Alright, so we'll just snug her down. Tighten it down. All right, we'll get the cable untwisted. Let me pick you guys up.
We'll get the cable untwisted, and then I'll route it back over to the appropriate spot on the passenger side valve cover. But see the plastic clips here, they're already in place. And there's another one down there behind that bracket. There you go. So I'll put that in its spot, that one back in its spot, and then we're good to go. So we'll see you in the next clip. Okay, I've got the blue cable routed behind the engine block as it was originally, and put the peg in the hole right there. Just lining all of the cables up the way they were before. Something like that. I've got that reusable tie wrap right here, which we'll go ahead and put back in there. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. So we'll put this back in as originally installed. We've made sure that this blue cable isn't caught up on anything. And last step, besides putting the bracketry back together, is to connect the connector. So I just made it up. All right, so get it to slide in a little bit. Again, it should not take much pressure if it doesn't want to go in initially. It could be because the pins are misaligned, but take your time. See, it's not going in, so we'll go ahead and check the pins in here. Everything's still straight, so it's just a matter of getting everything to line up exactly right for the stars to cross or a line, depending on how you want to look at things. It's clicked in, locked in, nice and secure. Go ahead and slide this onto the bracket on top of the valve cover. All right. It's incredibly hard working behind the camera. Just hope you guys can appreciate this. So that's connected. The other one's connected. Lines are secure. So the only thing left is to route the cable, the throttle cable, back to where it should go. That one's there. There's a bracket that fits right there on the master cylinder. And we'll clip everything back together. I'll do that here in the next clip. All right, give it the classic reach around. My sleeves just don't get stuck on anything. This camera would focus. What crummy footage, huh? Okay, that's snug. It's the only thing I unbolted on this side. So make sure the throttle cable is in its little spot there, and its spot over there, back around. Now we'll just put everything back the way it came originally. There's two little nuts here, I guess. You want to line that bracket up in between those two nuts. Snap it in. Same thing right there. Snap it in. Got the evap lines here. You moved them. Go ahead and line them back up the way they're supposed to be. All right. So just do a double check that you've put everything back together, clear your tools, and you're pretty much done. And I will show you something that I saw just a second ago. So this is the original O2 sensor, as you can see here, maybe. It says Bosch on it. And there's a Nissan emblem right there. Ooh. There's a Nissan emblem. Bosch. So that explains why I've had really good luck on these Nissans using Bosch O2 sensors. It's because they make the factory part. So save some money, just buy them from the aftermarket, just get a good quality Bosch O2 sensor. There's no need to go to the Nissan dealer unless they give you a good discount or something. And there we go. Anyway, that's how you do the O2 sensors, the upstream O2 sensors on a Nissan with a big 3.3 V6. Hope you like this video and that it was helpful for you. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And if you like the video, go ahead and click the like button and feel free to leave any comments on this video on video ideas maybe, or anything else that you have any questions or concerns about. So until next time, have a great day.